Temperatures are starting to drop. Winter is almost here, and skiers and snowboarders, myself included, are very excited to return to the slopes this season. So let's talk about what we could expect demand-wise. And for that, we want to bring in Rusty Gregory. He's the CEO of Alterra Mountain Company. Rusty, it's good to see you. Last year's season was plagued by the rise in number of COVID cases. Many mountains were restricting the number of skiers that were able to ski on a daily basis. We also had those travel restrictions. Now this year, that isn't necessarily the case. So what should we expect this winter season from some of your biggest mountains?
Well, I think a lot of fun. The season's off to a good start. We have some resorts in the West that are open already. And, you know, we are coming out of the pandemic, and we're very optimistic about a fun season. We won't have the capacity restrictions we had last year, things will be back to normal as closely as we can see as we look into the future. So I think people will be looking for resorts to be welcoming them back, and we're really quite excited about the season we're about to have.
Rusty, I was muted. Sorry about that. It's great to hear that there's snow out west. Are temperatures, though, going to be cool enough on this part of the country, the eastern side of the country? It's warm today in New York for November. And I'm wondering what kind of snowpack is there going to be as we head toward December for people who want to go, skiing anywhere between Chicago and northern Maine?
You know, Adam, I'm sitting here in New York, actually, looking out at Central Park. It's beautiful, warm. It looks more like springtime than it does winter, but it's still plenty early enough. And, my 40 years in the business, I'm not sure it's empirical evidence, but the seasons that sort of come right at the last minute that surprise us with temperatures and last minute snow, those are the ones, seriously, that seem to have the most momentum. So I'm actually very optimistic about the conditions we're seeing and the weather patterns that are shaping up both in the East and in the West, frankly.
Well, Rusty, this does bring up the topic of climate talks. We have COP26 coming to a close today, but how is the industry at large, when you're talking with some of your peers out there, how are you rallying together to combat climate change?
It's a huge issue. We're really the canary in the coal mine, if you consider the lifestyle and the sport of skiing and the reliance on snow. So, if anyone should be focused on it, it's the ski industry. And our approach is really one that's unique to our business model, which is focusing on the individual resorts and the unique opportunities that they have. For instance, Mammoth Mountain, where I spent a lot of years, has a tremendous geothermal resource right in town. So the possibility of an over-the-fence agreement that directly connects Mammoth and the community to that power source and to the cogeneration, for instance, of hot geothermal water for snow melting. That's an example of something that we can really do. Carbon offsets and the markets for that are, certainly a credible way to do it as well. But I think that there's nothing like actually on the ground changes in our carbon footprint. So we're looking for those opportunities at each one of our resorts and working on acting on them.
When we talk about the passes that skiers like to buy, what kind of momentum do you see there? And because we're coming out of this pandemic with so much pent-up demand, are there deals to be had? Or are you able to maybe raise prices without people complaining?
You know, Adam, there's always deals to be had every year, every day. And no difference now. We've seen tremendous growth in our pass sales for the last 4 years. Alterra is a combination of a lot of resorts that have existed for quite some time, but that are now being pulled together through Alterra Mountain Company. So the Icon Pass, we're in our fourth year of sales, and this is the highest percentage year-over-year increase that we've already experienced, and there's still a month or so to go in our sales. So we've been very encouraged by that, and it's really a great trade for our guests, because the trade of coming a lot and paying in advance of the season provides them the benefit that they've got really unlimited and significant numbers of day skiing at all of our resorts. And it's been in very, very hot demand as people come out of the pandemic and want to get out of their basements and off of Zoom calls and out in the nature and having a good time.
I can relate to that. Rusty, what about the labor shortage? We've been talking about the fact that so many companies simply can't find the workers. I'm sure you're out there hiring as fast as you can right now in order to get your mountains operating at full capacity. Can you find the workers you need?
You know, it's a big deal. We can find the workers that we need because as people come out of their basement and want to get outside, they head for the mountains. The big challenge will be the housing in the mountains. A lot of other people beat them to it that are seasonal employees. The people that came and worked in a different locations instead of the heavily populated urban areas, we all found that we could live in great places and be on calls like this one to do our business. So that's filled up a lot of the available bed base that would otherwise be available for local workers, managers, and that's quite a challenge for us this year. So in the short term, we are locking up housing in advance through lease agreements, and we're spending and committing significant capital over the next 3 to 5 years to actually build company-controlled housing in each one of our locations. So that's been one of the major disruptions of the pandemic that we've noticed the most. But the good news is our workers and the people like me that started their careers off going and running a ski lift, they want to come and they want to be to the mountains. So we'll find a way to take care of them.
Well, we wish you the best this upcoming ski season. Rusty Gregory, CEO of Alterra Mountain Company. Thanks so much.